Gavin Matter custard, snot and bogey pie, dead dog's giblets, green cat's eye, spread it on bread, spread it on thick, wash it all down with a cup of cold sick.
What's up, guys? Nikki Novak here in the Young Hollywood studio with One for the Money star, Jason O'Mara.
How are you?
What is Irish soda bread?
The real Irish soda bread is, it's like concrete, basically.
Got it.
But it's there's this kind of an Irish soda bread they make here with cake, and that's not it. That's like what we call fruitcake.
We should tell everybody, you posted a recipe on, it was an article or something, where you were talking about making Irish soda bread.
I want to open this debate. What is real traditional Irish soda bread?
You got to be able to have it with a beer.
Well, no, it's more of a breakfast thing.
However, really? I thought it was Sunday dinner thing. Isn't there
a traditional... If you have beer for breakfast, that's okay. I'm just not sure.
Isn't that the Irish way? I've got a good impersonation for you.
Go ahead.
Joe Morelli, what's your problem?
That's it?
That was bad, wasn't it?
It wasn't great.
That was my attempt to do a New Jersey accent.
Good to see you, Cupcake.
How comfortable are you with the lowlife? So lingerie for 3 years in Newark. You're good to go. Joe Morelli skipped out on bail. 50 grand dead or alive. I can do this.
Cupcake. I saw that on your Twitter. You tweeted that you were coming to LA and you were getting a...
California Cupcake.
What's California Cupcake?
No, I just was having fun because it's all about Cupcake. You know, he calls her Cupcake.
You're sexy as hell.
To see you, Cupcake!
Yeah, so you and Katherine, you had some pretty crazy scenes. There was a scene with her in the shower.
Yeah.
Who was more uncomfortable?
I was perfectly comfortable. I could have stayed there all day. In fact, I did.
Did you now?
Yeah, I could have brought a packed lunch. In fact, I did. I was just like, how's it going? What's going on? And she was just like, I've got to make it.
Oh, come on.
I want my car and I want it now.
How does a person eat like you eat and look like you look?
With my tasty cake.
I don't think any of the men in the screen, I was watching the screening, none of the men in the theater minded that at all.
No.
They were hating you.
Yeah, I was the lucky boy that day. It was a dirty, big film set. There were a lot of dirty, big film grips working on it.
I thought you were going to say dirty, big film producers, but I didn't.
Well, there were, actually, as well. And she had to kind of go around, like, you know, naked. It was a tough day for her, and she was a trooper, to be honest. When the cameras were rolling, we really started to have fun with the characters. You know, we started making stuff up, and, you know, her talking about messing with my tasty cakes, all that stuff was improvised. And,
oh, it was?
Yeah, so that's when it really gets fun.
Because, you know, the movie's based on a novel. So
it
when
is?
You're... Yes.
Can't wait to see what you got.
They blew up our car.
Excuse me, whose car?
Your car. You want it back?
You play a very dangerous man. And it was incredible because you're on Terra Nova as well. And on Terra Nova, you're such a great family man. I mean, I know who you are, but I couldn't even tell it was the same person. If I didn't know, it is a complete...
Acting my dear.
I saw on your website.
Yeah.
You have something, it's called impromptu interview time.
Yeah.
I'm turning around on you.
Oh no, you've got to be joking. You can't
I'm
do that.
I'm doing it.
It's a registered trademark.
Will you give me permission?
Yeah, okay.
What you normally do is you normally turn the cameras, you have a little handheld, and you ask people impromptu questions.
The day has arrived. I'm so happy.
I'm turning it around.
Unbelievable.
Recommend a book or film. We know the film, One for the Money.
One for the Money is the film, obviously.
Yeah.
The book, I fell in love with The Catcher in the Rye when I was 15.
What's on your iPod?
I'm listening to The Black Keys. I love Kasabian, Foster the People.
You have kids. You don't have any Miley Cyrus or anything like that on your iPod?
I'm not going to talk about that or admit it.
If you weren't an actor, you'd be?
A doctor.
I thought you were going to say dog for something. I was like, what? What celebrity, you're going to hate me for this one, what celebrity have you worked with that you want to spill the beans on? They could be good beans. They don't have to be bad beans.
Okay, good beans. Katherine Heigl is much nicer than some people make her out to be. How's that?
Can you recite, what's Fungus the Bogeyman? What is that?
Fungus the Bogeyman?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. You're totally killing me here. These are like ninja things up your sleeve that you didn't tell me about.
That's right, I'm a secret ninja.
Okay, so Fungus the Bogeyman, it was like for kids, but it was beautifully written, lovely stories. And one of the poems from Fungus the Bogeyman, I'm so embarrassed, was, and it's supposed to be gross, because these like bogeymen like come up and give people boils in the middle of the night, like, you know, zits on their neck. And the poem was, scabbin' matter custard, snottin' bogey pie, dead dog's giblets, green cat's eye, spread it on bread, spread it on thick, wash it all down with a cup of cold sick.